Hello, my name is Andy Card. I'm coach of the men's lightweight crew here at Yale. Yale's been around since 1701. The gym has been around since 1921. I've been around Yale since 1989, and I've been working with UL for the last 3 years, and they've been great years, and I look forward to another year this year. You're gonna start here in the tank A of the Payne Whitney gym. You see behind me to the right is a full tank with water that duplicates or imitates as best that humans can what we do on the water. And behind me to my left, you can see a lot of the various contraptions, machines, and weights that we use to get in condition and stay in condition through the long winter months before we go back on the river in the spring and compete for Yale. You'll be starting here, as I mentioned. You'll be starting on the rowing ergometers, which we're gonna show you in a little while, and you're gonna be also rowing in the tanks for just a little bit to give you a taste of the awesomeness that is rowing that you'll experience the very next day when we go out on the river at Derby and learn what makes boats go. We're here at the tank level A to remind you a little bit about what rowing really is. Rowing is hard work. It can be glorious, thrilling work if you work together with your teammates to move your boat as fast as possible at the right time. You need to be quite organized and strong in your whole body, your legs, torso, and arms, working in coordination against the oar and the water in order to propel your boat as fast as possible. Rowing is work, your oar is your tool, it's your lever to use in coordination with the rest of your teammates over and over again. It's also like dancing, like the Rockettes. Their coordination and timing is exquisite, and that's what we'll be trying to drill with you here in Tank A on the very first day. You'll need to learn how to get your body prepared to take the next stroke and to work hard against the water, and then how to relax and let your body go and recover and prepare for the very next stroke. It's a lot like dancing. If you're a great dancer, you're going to do very well. If you're a good athlete, you'll be able to do very well. And if you're not, we're gonna work hard together over the next few months to make sure that you become one. Everyone is an athlete. Some are trained, some are not. We're gonna come together this summer here in Tank A and take our first step on the journey for the 2012 UL Rowing Camp. So let's talk about work and rowing. The Concept 2 rowing machine is the standard around the globe for measuring work as far as rowing is concerned. Olympic teams, national teams, universities and colleges, high schools, all use this machine to assess the fitness of their athletes. We'll be using this machine in three ways. The first is to show you the basic movements of rowing before we hop into the tanks. The second is to assess your current fitness. What are you bringing to the table today? The third is to help you use this machine and improve your fitness level. Pick any sport that comes to mind. Think about what athletes in that sport look like. Basketball, tall, of course. Marathon running, skinny and fast. Rugby and football, big and strong, big, maybe hefty. Gymnastics, typically female, not exclusively so, but short little pixies, teenage girls. In rowing, there is no gender or size bias. You can be male or female, tall or short, skinny or heavier, it really doesn't matter. The best rowers around the world do have one commonality though. They have a high strength to weight ratio. We are seeking through the camp and through your months of training prior to the camp to improve you and the UL team in either of those areas, preferably both, but let's pick one. Improve your strength, improve your body weight, it doesn't matter. You just need to get better. To help you improve your strength to weight ratio, Yale's gonna give you a fantastic bundle of exercise bands and an instruction manual, which I hope you take advantage of no matter where you find yourself on the globe, whether you're in an over-luxurious hotel room or some dreary cookie-cutter Holiday Inn. Use these bands and you're gonna get better. Welcome to the Housatonic River and Yale Gilder Boathouse. Behind me is the river. It's fresh water, it's dammed at both ends, and that means you can swim in it. After every row, it's a fantastic treat. Hope you take advantage of it. This is your classroom, and what's terrific about this classroom is that not only can you reap the rewards of all your hard work in the months leading up to the camp, but also you can feel your teammates working hard also in a direct way that cannot be replicated in any hard surface classroom, if you will. This is our liquid surface classroom. I think you're going to really enjoy that aspect of the camp, and working together is one of the most primary and basic lessons that rowing has to offer you. The first day that you're here, you guys will perform, and it's a fun task, of the swim test. Basically, you jump in at one end of the dock, swim upstream to the other end of the dock, and then tread water for 5 minutes. If you're a good swimmer, this should be no problem at all. If you can't swim, now is a great time to start hopping in a pool, finding a teacher, finding some lessons, finding a coach, and becoming a little more proficient in your swimming ability. A number of UL campers have learned to swim after the camp, and it's been a tremendous life-changing experience. If you still are uncomfortable getting on the water in the camp, then we do have life preservers that you can wear throughout your time on the water, and it's no problem. Typically, I will say that unless you choose to jump in after your row, most UL campers, in fact, every UL camper, stays in the boat and doesn't get flipped out. Although I will say it is possible, but extremely rare. Let's talk about your pre-work for rowing camp. Before you guys get here in July, we're all gonna have to work pretty hard to get in condition for the camp. How that's gonna happen is I'm gonna communicate with you through a blog. I'm gonna post workouts every day. You're gonna do them, and then you're gonna send me and the rest of the group the feedback about your particular workouts. The format is pretty simple. Every day I'll post the blog, you look at it, you do it, and then you post up your results after the workout. If you do nothing, you'll still post, I did nothing today. Or if it's a rest day, you can post up whatever you did for that rest day. I drank more water than usual, for example, or I ate a lot of red food, like strawberries. Whatever, it's a lighthearted effort, it's not that serious, but the only serious part is that you do have to post every day what you did. The importance of being accountable is incredibly powerful, and you guys have the chance to do this blog experience better than any of the other three groups that we've had so far. I'm counting on you guys to get the job done. A couple more things about the blog. The feedback we've gotten from the other three groups has been overwhelmingly, man, I wish I had gotten more involved in all the workouts in the pre-work phase. I wish I had posted the blog more. I wish I had invested a little more effort there, because knowing what I know now, i.e. after having rowed here in the camp, I wish I had done a little bit more. So don't be that guy or that person to have that regret afterward. The second thing is when I get feedback from the group, when I see that you guys are working out and you're asking questions, and how do I do this? Or can you give me a video to demonstrate that? Or how do I use a curb to do my jumps? Whatever it is, that's motivating for me. And it's a positive feedback loop. When the team is, I try to motivate you guys to do the workouts, you do the workouts, you give me feedback back. It's a tremendously positive loop. It's a really a lot of fun, and it'll just make our time together here in the Pew Bay at the Gilder Boathouse and on the Housatonic River that much more satisfying. So get to work. ELP4, listen, we've got a challenging task ahead of us. You guys have to train very hard on your own, posting all to the blog, et cetera, et cetera. We've already discussed that. Get ready to perform when you're here. If you're in pretty good shape here, then it can be all about learning how to move a boat well together. And we're gonna need to do that in a very short amount of time, because the ELP3s are coming to town in the second week, and they've had about 3 weeks of rowing experience, 3 weeks more than you have. We've gotta put it all together in 2 weeks and beat ELP3.